I'm not completely happy with how this build is going, but I have solutions, which is to build more stuff to help me build the stuff. So in this episode, I'm going to show you this extremely small ship I'm calling my control pod, which might also be an ideal ship for someone starting out in space. I'll also show you the first peek at the interior of my engineering deck and a couple more bits right now. So the space station build is going pretty well, and I have to say that having the wall builder continuously constructing any of the straighter, regular, block-shaped parts is like having an extra player helping with the construction, albeit a slow player, but a slow and steady builder is far better than none at all. It's allowed me to go do other things like hand place the next uniquely shaped wall section, or even start to build out part of my engineering room, while the automated drone is busy doing its thing. There is one small thing, though, that I'm not managing very well, and that's my own energy and oxygen while using my drones. Let me explain. On the outside of my base, you've seen me use the walled skimmer drone to build some of the more angled wall sections. Even though I have cameras on the drone, it's still really convenient to leave the camera view and look at things from different angles. And like I talked about in my ship to station video, the wall builder drone pushes around the station a little bit. So I need to continuously go between viewing things from the outside as well as the camera view to maintain my perspective. To do that, I've been just floating in space nearby where I'm building. This has the problem, though, of me slowly running out of energy and oxygen, which means I have to leave the remote control of the drone, dash somewhere to recharge and gas up, then return to where I was, and re-establish remote control of the drone. This was also true on the interior of the ship, where I was building out piping and thrusters. These periodic interruptions were getting to be a pain, and because I was in the drone's remote control, I wouldn't always get the low energy warning messages.
Energy critical.
My character would just start taking damage from the lack of energy or oxygen. But I fixed that with this control pod. I only needed this tiny little ship to do four things: keep my suit charged, keep my oxygen filled, move me around the station where I needed to be to get a good look at things, and control my drones from the safety of the pod. So I built this thing very purpose-driven and used a slightly different construction assembly than what I've done in the past. I started with a connector, but rather than going to a conveyor junction or a cargo container like I might normally do, I went straight to an oxygen tank with a big battery on the bottom. I had no intention of moving any cargo with the thing, so started by going straight to those essentials. The industrial cockpit also has two small ports that happen to line up perfectly with the two small ports on the back side of the oxygen tank. After that, I used ion thrusters and placed two in each direction. Two facing left and right at the back, two facing forwards and backwards stacked on top of each other, and two more sets facing up and down that were side by side. I also took a little care to ensure that there were two blocks of free space from the end of the thruster so I wouldn't burn any blocks. Now, you can use this same configuration on the full gravity of the Earth-like planet, simply by replacing the ion thrusters with the atmospheric ones. True, the atmospheric ones are three blocks long, and these are only two, but the atmospheric thrusters only burn one block distance from the end, so you should be just fine. Also, weight-wise, this pod is slightly over 12,000 in mass, and two small grid, small atmospheric thrusters will lift a little over 19,000 mass in the Earth-like gravity, which should be plenty of headroom for lift and maneuverability. After the thrusters, it was time for a few more functional blocks, along with some decorative ones. I think the rounded blocks give it that pod feel, and helps lose some of that cubic nature that's so easy to wind up with on builds like this. It has two gyroscopes, though I only need one. I use two for aesthetic balance, and I might replace one of them with something else later. I placed an all-important antenna to be able to control my drones, and so I can access the projectors on my main station grid to remotely move and set up the projections for the modular station walls. So I don't even have to leave my pod to do that. The pod also needed an array of lights. Of course, what's a cool ship without lights? Two spotlights, two interior lights, and a movable searchlight on the bottom. One of the things I'm happiest about are the two light panels I also placed and made a blue color, and set so the radius reflects this really nice bluish hue over most of the other ship parts. It gives it a special vibe that makes me really like this build. I know, it's just a visual, but aesthetics do make a big difference in this game between falling in love with one of your builds or just creating something to do the job. As far as doing the job, this little ship is excellent. I never have to worry about running out of power or oxygen while operating my drones. And so far, I've spent many, many hours and game sessions operating solely out of this little ship, and never have drained the battery past 50%. And that's with me flying it all around, back and forth, across the space station a fair bit. As far as the oxygen tank barely dips into its supply, so running out of O2 isn't even a consideration. The longevity of survival makes this little control pod an excellent ship for servers where the game continuously runs and your character continuously uses energy and oxygen, even while logged off. It's not going to use those resources as efficiently as a cryo chamber, but if you're on a server and off exploring asteroids for resources or on the surface of a moon or planet and need to log out of the game, I think this cheap-to-build pod would keep you alive, energized, and oxygenated until at least the next day when you could log back in. Its small size has also made it perfect for operating inside of my engineering deck, where I'm putting in the piping and a significant array of hydrogen thrusters to be able to move the station around. I'm putting 12 in each direction because I think the station is going to be super heavy when it's finished, between the weight of the station and all the resources it'll pack. I was afraid the large ion thrusters that I really wanted to use just wouldn't have enough oomph to push it around effectively. I figured they'd move it, and I'm not too concerned about having to lay into the thrusters for 2 or 3 minutes to get it up to speed. It was more about stopping the behemoth that I was worried about, you know, flying it into an asteroid or something. I would be really curious to hear from you all in the comments if you think I went overboard with 12 large hydrogen thrusters. I've just never built anything at this scale before. The convenience of this control pod has been great. It's kind of like having a mobile charging station that I can park right next to where I'm working. I do spend a fair bit of time outside of the pod, laying down framework blocks for the next piece of station to blueprint for a construction module. You can see what that's about in my last video. But it saves me from either having to constantly build a little charging chair or having to fly back to a charging station. I can just jump in the pod, charge up, get some air, and continue working. And if I need to observe a drone or work on another part of the station, I hop in and go. In fact, I can't even remember the last time I had to change out a hydrogen or oxygen bottle or go anywhere else to charge my suit. It's just super convenient. I may even try to incorporate a version of this pod into a little tram system to get around the base, but we'll see about that. Let me know what you think of this little pod in the comments, and I have an idea for another needed build, so tune in next time to see what that's about. And I'll be talking to you later.